Good morning, everybody. Well, now it's just been time because it's 12:05, so let's start. First of all, welcome to all of you as attendees of this fourth workshop on technology for healthcare and healthy lifestyle. And welcome to this university where Ithaca's Institute and especially the group of technologies for health and well-being is always trying to create a forum for ideas and best practices around health and well-being. That's the idea of this workshop, where we are not looking for so many people, but we are looking for clever people, people with very high interest in this field. And well, I guess that we will enrich each other, because if you have analyzed or you have read the program, today we will have different speeches regarding health, but from different disciplines. I mean, we are going to talk about the how we can use YouTube videos for health literacy, and how patients can look in a better approach for reliable videos. We will discuss also about electronic health records and the importance for physicians, because okay, we are always supporting electronic health records, but sometimes the question is why and who is using such electronic health records. So people is going to perform a presentation. Or even we are going to discuss about how smart packaging can improve the patient safety and also work on the risk assessment side. We will also have a poster outside where you can also discuss with the author, well, in English or in Spanish. And that's the idea. Coming back to English, maybe you will realize that well, most of you are Spanish and you are talking in Spanish, but this the original idea, because this is the fourth edition, was to make it happen in English, because in such a way it allows us to involve and to engage people from different countries that can also participate, as in this case Gustav. And also because this is a chance for all of us to be aware about the importance of English, because that's the way we have just to communicate with a larger people our results, and also the impact of our research. It's much higher when we are publishing in English instead of Spanish. So let's do it in English, because also do it in this way, we will practice and we will force people to think about the importance of English, just to avoid, like last week, sentences like, I don't know if you heard about Mariano Rajoy, and it's very difficult to todo esto. Let's try to avoid these sentences and push forward, because okay, we have to defend our language, Spanish, but we have also to defend our ideas in a common language for all the people. So let's use English to put in practice all these topics. In any case, tomorrow the workshop will focus for a better discussion, and just to make that English is not a barrier for all the people. We will be talking about health literacy, what's alfabetización digital en sanidad, especialmente para el paciente, where as there are very huge differences between English and Spanish approaches. At the end, this round table would happen in Spanish. So today the presentation would happen in English, and tomorrow everything is in Spanish. I also mentioned previously that this year, because every year we focus on a specific topic that we want to go deeper, and this year is health literacy. What's health literacy in Spanish is alfabetización digital en salud, and is just pushing for the importance of the patient and education, because when we are talking about any problem that is currently happening in the Spanish society, at the end In most of the cases, it doesn't matter if we are talking unemployment or about crisis or about whatever, the basis is education. So here also on health, we need to see how we can get the maximum return of investment, and education and health literacy is playing a major role on those issues. As example, I was 2 weeks 2 weeks ago in the HEPAC, a congress arranged by patients with cancer, where more than 3,000 patients with cancer meet together. It was a huge conference, even better than different medical scientific conference, where they were fully aware about the importance of being together and just to exchange knowledge, but not only from a medical perspective. And that's what we are also trying here, just to involve patients and to involve different disciplines. I mean, here we are not talking about only medical imaging or process mining, we are discussing about health and the importance to keep healthy. Just to end before giving the floor for the next for the first session and the speakers, let's really appreciate all the people who have been involved in the organization of the workshop. So thank you, Aticha, thank you, Manolo, thank you especially Carlos, that has been pushing all the people and being taking care of all everything. And also thank you, technicians, attendees, and also the UPB, just to allow us to host this event and to make it possible. You have the agenda, but in any case, just also to summarize that today, after the first session, we will have a lunch here. We will have also the discussion, the time for networking and discussion about different ideas. After that, a new session. The first session will be chaired by Dr. Carlos Fernandez, and the second session will be chaired by me. And tomorrow we will have two round tables, just in the middle, there will be a coffee that will be chaired by Dr. Ignacio Pasagoiti. So, nothing more from my side. Thank you all for your attendance, and let's give the floor to Dr. Carlos Fernandez. Thank you.